Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer.
Our psalm this morning is Psalm number 26, and I invite you to join in the bold. Vindicate me, O Lord, for I have walked in my integrity, and I have trusted in the Lord without wavering.
Prove me, O Lord, and try me. Test my heart and mind.
For your steadfast love is before my eyes, and I can walk in faithfulness to you.
I do not sit with the worthless, nor do I consort with the hypocrites.
I hate the company of evildoers, and will not sit with the wicked.
I wash my hands in innocence, and go round your altar, O Lord.
Singing aloud a song of thanksgiving and telling all your wondrous deeds.
O Lord, I love the house in which you dwell and the place where your glory abides.
Do not sweep me away with sinners, nor my life with the bloodthirsty.
Those in whose hands are evil devices,
and whose right hands are full of bribes.
But as for me, I walk in my integrity. Redeem me and be gracious to me.
My foot stands on level ground. In the great congregation, I will bless the Lord.
God of love and mercy, give us clean hands and pure hearts, that we may walk in innocence and come to your eternal dwelling, to praise you in the company of your saints forever.
Amen. Amen.
Our first reading for today comes from Job chapter 1, verse 1, followed by chapter 2, verses 1 through 10. There was once a man in the land of Uz, whose name was Job. That man was blameless and upright, one who feared God and turned away from evil. One day the heavenly beings came to present themselves before the Lord, and the accuser also came among them to present himself before the Lord. The Lord said to the accuser, "Where have you come from?" The accuser answered the Lord, "From going to and fro on the earth, and from walking up and down on it." The Lord said to the accuser, "Have you considered my servant Job? There is no one like him on the earth, a blameless and upright man who fears God and turns away from evil. He still persists in his integrity, although you incited me against him to destroy him for no reason." Then the accuser answered the Lord, "Skin for skin, all that the man has he will give for his life. But stretch out your hand now and touch his bone and his flesh, and he will curse you to your face." The Lord said to the accuser, "Very well, he is in your power, only spare his life." So the accuser went out from the presence of the Lord, and inflicted loathsome sores on Job. From the sole of his foot to the crown of his head, Job took a potsherd with which to scrape himself and sat among the ashes. Then his wife said to him, "Do you still persist in your integrity? Curse God and die." But he said to her, "You speak as any foolish woman would speak. Shall we receive good from God and not receive evil?" In all this, Job did not sin with his lips. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
Thanks be to God.
Our second reading for today comes from Hebrews chapter 1, verses 1 through 5, followed by chapter 2, verses 5 through 10, through 12. Long ago, God spoke to our ancestors in many and various ways by the prophets. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son, whom he appointed heir of all things, through whom he also created the worlds. He is the reflection of God's glory and the exact imprint of God's very being. And he sustains all things by his powerful word. When he had made purification for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high. having become as much superior to angels as the name he has inherited is more excellent than theirs. Now God did not subject the coming world, about which we are speaking, to angels. But someone has testified somewhere, "What are human that you are mindful of them, or mortals that you care for them? You have made them from a little while lower than the angels. You have crowned them with glory and honor, subjecting all things under their feet. Now in subjecting all things to them, God left nothing outside their control. As it is, we do not yet see everything in subjection to them. But we do see Jesus, who for a little while was made lower than the angels, now crowned with glory and honor because of the suffering of death, so that by the grace of God he might taste death for everyone. It was fitting that God, from whom and through whom all things exist, in bringing many children to glory, should make the pioneer of salvation perfect through sufferings. For the one who sanctifies, that those who are sanctified all have one Father. For this reason, Jesus is not ashamed to call them brothers and sisters, saying, I will proclaim your name to my brothers and sisters. In the midst of the congregation, I will praise you. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
Thanks be to God.
I keep fighting voices in my mind that say I'm not enough. Every single lie that tells me I will never measure up. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low? Remind me once again just who I am, because I need to know. Ooh, oh, you say I am loved when I can't feel a thing. And you say I am strong when I think I am weak. You say I am held when I am falling short. When I don't belong, oh, you say now is everything you think of me. In you I find my worth, in you I find my identity. Oh, you say I am loved when I can't feel a thing. You say
you say I am yours.
gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Some testing him asked, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife?" And he answered them, "What did Moses command you?" They said, "Moses allowed a man to write a certificate of dismissal and to divorce her." But Jesus said to them, "Because of your hardiness of heart, he wrote this commandment for you. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife. And the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate." Then in the house, the disciples asked him again about this matter. And he said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her. And if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery. People were bringing children to him in order that he might touch them, and the disciples spoke sternly to them. But when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said to them, "Let the children come to me. Do not stop them, for it is such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. Truly I tell you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will never enter it." And he took them up in his arms, laid his hands on them, and blessed them. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This one we should all know.
And those who have contacted us for one concern or another, we are grateful for your gifts and your presence. Thank you for your generous donations and giving. We pray that the risen Lord bless and multiply all that you do you and all that you do. And before we send you off, we're going to do a little different today. We're going to talk about Christy Action. I'm going to remind you, and there's some cards you can take with you also. Christy Action, as defined by St. Thomas Anglican Church in Winnipeg. Living out our baptismal covenants in everything we do, with everyone we meet, and everywhere we go. In other words, to live a Christ-like life as actively, consciously, and thoughtfully as we can. And from the Bishop's Charge of 2022, you and I have many an obligation to commend the faith that is in us, to speak the power of God, and affirm others by seeing and serving Christ in all persons, loving our neighbors as ourselves. So go forth into the world, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit, and be what you are, the church in the world.
Thanks be to God. Amen. Alleluia.